stumble out of bed and I stumble to the kitchen. Pour myself a cup of ambition and
yawn. A little Dolly Parton to get the morning started off right. And it turns out that women can turn some challenges at work into opportunities. Business coach, author, and entrepreneur Christy Wright shares her advice in the book that's called Business Boutique. Thank you so much for being here.
Thank you for having me. Glad to be here.
So I'm, you know, this actually starts out when we're like little girls.
Right.
Like, I mean, you basically say that like at age six, that's when little girls start to not be risk takers, shall we say. They're just
right.
A little more timid than the boys.
Right. It's so interesting because a lot of women that I work with when I'm coaching them in their businesses, they feel like they're the only one that feels this way. But it's true that it's a generalization, but many women mm-hmm. experience more fear. So research shows that as early as childhood, little girls are a little more cautious. So I'll give you an example.
Okay.
Girls break sooner when riding their bikes, research shows. We're just a little bit more risk averse and we don't like to make the same mistake twice.
Right.
But you think of the implication of this in business, you've got to take risk if you're going to put yourself out there in business. So you can actually turn this into an opportunity by realizing that fear is just a normal part of the journey. It doesn't mean you're doing something bad. It means you're doing something bold. So just get comfortable with it and you can still put yourself out there.
Yeah, you talk a lot about fear in the book and you said really it's fear that just shuts women down. And
yes.
And what I thought was interesting and I thought was a really good point is you say, write it down, whatever your goal is or whatever
yes.
you want to do, write it down. It's kind of like saying it out loud.
Yes.
You're also writing it down and that's going to make it so when you hear those voices in your head saying, you can't do this,
right.
or that's
already
you? Been
yeah.
done, or why do you think you can do
right.
this? You say that's really something that can turn that around and kind of shut off that.
Sure.
That
when you write something down, it becomes tangible in the real world outside of this battleground of your thoughts. And
right.
that's a really powerful step.
All right, women are more relational, an advantage in business, obviously. We're really good at relationships.
Right.
But we're really not very assertive, and that can hurt us.
It can. It's got both sides to it. So, for example, we value ourselves by our relationships, which is a great asset. And so we're fantastic at customer service. We are great at taking care of people and being nurturing and put ourselves in their shoes and that type of thing.
Right.
But then you think about, well, I've got to price my products, or I've got to sell my product and I don't want to
That's
be pushy,
hard.
Or how do I set policies, or even in a work environment, how do I ask for a raise? And so when
right.
you realize that this is an asset, but it can also be an opportunity where this is something where you can focus on what you're giving, not what you're getting. So for example,
yeah.
don't focus on getting money from people, focus on the value you're offering through your business or in the work environment.
Multitasking, that's something we're great at.
Yes, we're proud
so
multitaskers.
Yes,
like,
we
I'm
are.
So good at multitasking. But here's the thing, when we try to give our attention in more than one area,
yeah.
one area will slip. So I'll give you an example. If you are trying to talk to someone while they're texting,
uh-huh.
they're not paying attention. Our brain can only focus on one area at a time. So
yeah.
instead, if you want to multitask effectively, give your attention in one area. You can have the crock pot going, you can
yeah.
be folding towels, but only give your attention in one area.
That's funny because my husband will be, I'm talking and I'm doing something else. My husband's like, whoa. I can only do one thing at a
yeah,
time.
Yeah.
Tell me what you just said.
Right,
I'm like,
yeah.
why didn't you hear me?
Yeah, we need some focus.
All right, so you're going to be signing your book. I want to
yes.
let everyone know tonight at 6 at the Barnes & Noble that's right across from Northwest Highway, right across from North Park that's on Northwest Highway. And you can find a link to Business Boutique on our website, fox4news.com. A lot of really good tips in here. Thank you for coming by. We appreciate it.
Thanks for having me.
Coming up.